Trucks arrive with the first and second stage of Ariane 6 at the Launcher Assembly Building in Kourou. Here, both stages are assembled horizontally before being transported to the mobile gantry for further integration. This is the process each Ariane 6 will go through. This simplifies the preparation process, just as in a car factory assembly line, and soon it will be put into practice at Europe's spaceport. Here, the construction of the new launch base for Ariane 6 is in its finalization phase. On one side, the launcher assembly building, and then the launch pad itself, with the big mobile gantry. Here, Ariane 6's boosters and fairing with payloads will be fitted. Ariane 6 facilities are taking shape. Europe's future launchers are becoming reality.
So first, Ariane 6, the development goes full speed ahead. And now industry has started the production of the first 14 launchers of Ariane 6 in addition to the maiden flight. So 15 launchers in production today. On Vega-C side, all engines are tested, and we had the test of the Zephyr 40, which was the last engine test. So now we are really on the final pass towards the maiden flight of Vega-C as well.
Vega-C is the new and enhanced version of Europe's lightweight launcher Vega. It will allow for an increased and versatile payload capacity from Kourou. In parallel, ESA is supporting the development of a structure to launch multiple satellites, called Small Spacecraft Mission Service. This dispenser allows more than a dozen small satellites to be launched under the fairing of Vega and then Vega-C, which will soon launch from Kourou for the first time.
We will have a proof of concept flight on Vega, allowing to launch light satellites, a big number of small satellites. And we are already now preparing the same for Vega-C and Ariane 6. So all our European launchers, which are in development today, will have the capacity to offer a launch of a number of small satellites, light satellites. It's a real market enhancement.
Another project for ESA is Space Rider. It is the continuation of the intermediate experimental vehicle, IXV, the successful mission that flew in February 2015. Space Rider is an unmanned orbital vehicle that should provide Europe with its first operational reusable space transportation system. It will be able to return from space and will allow for experiments in microgravity, in-orbit validation of technologies, deployment of small satellites, and might even be used for Earth observation applications or servicing missions.
We have today the access to space component, which is covered through Ariane 6 and Vega-C. We are developing at ESA STS Space Transportation also propulsion elements, engines for transport in space, and with Space Rider, we have an operational capability which will have to be decided in Sevilla end of the year for returning from space on Earth.
While the Ministerial Conference in Seville will decide on the further development of Space Rider, today, with its range of launch vehicles, Europe is already able to launch any type of satellite into any orbit. The new portfolio under development aims to further secure this approach on the commercial launcher market, and at the same time, ensures Europe's independent access to space in the future.